Before the evening gets much, much longer, we should thank Mr. Tony DeSantis for the use of the hall. It really is beautiful. Thank you, Tony. For a very special part of tonight's program, I'd like to turn you back now to the president of the Chicago chapter of the National Academy of Television Arts and Sciences, Channel 5 anchorman, Jim Ruddle. Jim?
Thank you, Bob. The Board of Governors is authorized to present a special award, a special honor, to a member or members of the Chicago television community who demonstrate the highest standards in their performance, not only within the industry, but also outside it. This year, one award was voted. It goes to a man who has contributed unstintingly to civic and charitable endeavors all around the Chicago area. He's compiled an unparalleled record in broadcasting and has become a symbol of his particular specialty in Chicago television. The list of his credits is unending. Former president of the Chicago chapter, a founding member. He is a holder of numerous awards, many Emmy awards, a member of the prestigious Lincoln Academy of the State of Illinois, the Baseball Commissioner's Award for Meritorious Service. He has announced World Series, Rose, Sugar, Orange Bowls, baseball and football All-Star Games, NFL Championship Game, Golden Gloves, probably hula hoops and skateboard contests as well. He began sports broadcasting on Chicago television 30 years ago for WGN-TV, and he's still at it, and I think it would be most appropriate if you all stood and said, hey, hey, as we confer the Governor's Award to Jack Brickhouse.
I would rather have one word of praise from any one of these pros than 1,000 from anyone else. So to get this is a little bit too much, Jim, I guarantee you. What a day for Chicago. Newhart flew in and worked for free. The Cubs beat Houston. Tonight, Steve Stone of the White Sox, a Chicago boy, threw a three-hit shutout for the White Sox at Cleveland. The last two items, courtesy of the Channel 9 Sports Department. I am so grateful to Irv Kupcinet, who came to me a long time ago and said, we'd like to have you be part of this academy. I'm so grateful for the opportunity to have been any part of it. I know what it is to win. I know what it is to lose these things. Although in my case, it never really bothered me if I lost one. I always slept like a baby. I slept for an hour, and then I'd wake up and I'd cry for an hour. With it all, I'm not gonna violate the order we got while the commercial was on. Please keep those acceptance speeches short. Thank you so very, very much, and we'll see you at the 40th.
As an indication of how things changed, this next station we feature had these listings in TV Guide 20 years ago. College prep English, college prep math, French through TV, and Einstein 3, or how to count in German. Here with its history is Chicago's public broadcasting station, WTTW, Channel 11.
In 1955, Dwight Eisenhower was president. Richard J. Daley was first elected mayor. And Channel 11 came on the air.
This is NET.
And in the beginning, there was the blackboard.
We could see after a while this would get to be laborious.
How, big Braves and little Braves?
Hi, boys and girls.
Hello, my friends. Welcome once more to the bookshelves of the storyteller.
Oh, hi. Hey, am I glad you're here, because you're just in time to play a really great game that I have made up.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. After the blackboard, became talk. And a lot of it was interesting.
I'm Bob Cromie from the Chicago Tribune. Thank you for being with us.
This is Julia Child. Bon appetit.
This is William F. Buckley, Jr.
Good evening. I'm Alistair Cooke.
I'm David Susskind.
And this is Lowell Thomas, as usual.
I'm Bill Moyers.
I'm Robert MacNeil.
I'm Roger Ebert.
I'm John Callaway.
And I'm Gene Siskel.
Hello, I'm Dick Cavett.
Irv Kupcinet saying goodbye.
Very glad you're with us this week and hope we see you again next week.
We've had a lot of people, and we've also had a lot of programs that look at the world around us and how it affects our lives.
This is the first voyage of the Space Shuttle Enterprise. Its mission? To make leaving the Earth as easy as flying around it.
For the first time on television, we can now witness the inner workings of the most awesome mechanism on this planet. Follow the eye of the camera as it journeys deep within man.
Everywhere atoms whir in a miniature universe. Have you ever wondered if the mystery of it all could be unlocked? Now, scientists around the world think they have found the key. In recent months, they have discovered new particles.
Times change, and programs change. But for years, Channel 11 has brought great performances from Chicago to the nation. In 23 years, Channel 11 has become the nation's most watched public television station.